In modern engines, you will find either a belt or a chain driving the shafts and ensuring they rotate with proper timing. This is crucial for proper valve opening and closing and piston movement. Once this symphony of an ICE engine is changed, you can get catastrophic engine damage because pistons can hit the valves and the engine may be even not worth repairing. To cut a long story short, the belt or the chain is a super important part of any modern internal combustion engine. The alternative is to connect the shafts with gears, but this creates a lot of noise and is not energy efficient at all. So everything was more or less good, but in the modern generation of engines, car manufacturers started freaking out a bit and installing thin chains, low quality belts, or over-engineering the systems of engine timing. About a decade ago, engineers were scratching their heads and trying to come up with another crazy idea on how to spoil internal combustion engines, and surprisingly they got the bright idea of making kind of a hybrid of a chain and a belt and called it the wet belt system. They moved the belt inside the engine and so it's lubricated by oil. They claimed that this should make the belt last for the entire lifespan of the engine. And they had a point, because when this belt kills your engine at 40,000 miles, this should be seen as the entire lifespan, shouldn't it? The bright examples of this technology are the 1.0 EcoBoost and 1.5 three-cylinder EcoBoost Ford engines, the 1.2 PureTech Peugeot engine, EcoBlue diesel engines in European Ford cars, and many more. So what is the problem? Actually, the wet belt will start degrading at about 40,000 miles or 60,000 kilometers, whatever you do. And it may also start degrading earlier if you use non-OEM oil. When the belt degrades, it sends debris to the sump of your engine, so the debris freely floats in the oil pan and will eventually be sucked into the oil intake and the pump. The smaller debris will get to the filter, while the larger pieces will stay in the oil pump, clogging it. The worst part is that you will know that there is a problem when the engine starts struggling from low oil pressure, and it will already be affected by this. The first years of all those wet belts, engines were more or less okay, but as engines started aging and got some miles on them, owners started reporting huge problems with clogged oil pumps and absolutely destroyed engines after low oil pressure and oil starvation issues. At first, companies started cutting the timing belt replacement intervals. Initially, there were no intervals at all. Then Ford claimed you should replace the belt at 150,000 miles, while Peugeot said it was 120,000 miles. But things got worse and worse each year. Now EcoBoost engines try to switch to chains, while Peugeot wants you to change the wet belt kit once every 60,000 miles. This is complete engineering nonsense, and I strongly recommend you avoid the wet belt engines in any form and type. The problem is that you will need to replace that belt kit once every 30-40,000 miles to avoid oil contamination, and also use exclusively OEM oil all the time. But changing this belt is not that simple. While the belt kit is not that expensive, the labor is going to be absolutely insane in terms of money. So the easiest way to avoid this problem is to avoid wet belt cars, and probably even think about getting rid of the vehicle with the wet belt engine, if you already own one. I hate giving such tips, but this is the situation when manufacturers heavily screwed up and are trying hard to protect themselves from immensely expensive recalls, rather than trying to find a solution and help car owners avoid the issue.